Firstly, we need to look at how a dog moves. What is happening? Where are the legs going? How do they move together? What's the head doing? The tail? You don't want to leave any observation out. I suggest watching your dog or finding some footage on YouTube and just paying close attention. You can use the full stop and comma keys on your keyboard to navigate through a YouTube video one frame at a time. This can be really helpful in seeing more closely what exactly is moving, where and when. When you have got a feel for the movement, you can draw down the key poses for reference. It can be helpful to shade the legs in different colours to help you see the position changes too. Four simple key poses with leg position changes. In my example, I plan to animate a corgi, and they have a really playful way of moving, which lends itself nicely to animation. They are quite bouncy and mischievous, and they're really fun to watch as well. If you ever find yourself needing cheering up, definitely check some corgi action out. I also didn't want to have to build an armature or rig my character. So instead, I sculpted my corgi dog four times, with each being a slightly different shape to match the drawings that I made in the previous step. You could do the same with paper cutouts, or you could make them out of felt. Anything goes. The most important thing is to have fun, and doing things this way will be a lot easier, especially when you're learning. To bring your dog to life, you'll want to photograph your sequence in your scene. I did mine flat down on glass, but you can photograph yours flat on any surface or tabletop. You can either swap them out each frame and line their feet up so the animation actually happens there and then, or, if you prefer working in the computer, you can photograph each dog in the same spot and then cut them out digitally and position them digitally too. I used this method when I made my film Rat Race last year.